Hello, my name's Adam Webb, and I'm going to show you how to install a Spigot servo on a Windows computer, 64-bit. First, you need to have a couple programs, Git and Java. As you can tell here, I got Git, and if I go here, I have Java. Now then, first thing you want to do is download BuildTools. So, I got it in my clipboard, so I'll paste it here. You can also get all the information on spigotmc.org. Links will be posted in the description. So now that I have BuildTools, now it's time to execute it. So I now type in java-jar BuildTools.jar. Now this process will take around approximately 10 to 15 minutes for the first one, as it's got to download all its files and compile everything together. And you see now it's pulling all the updates for the jar files, in which then it will start downloading the Minecraft files themselves, start compiling the server jar. As I said before, since this is the first one, it will take approximately about 10 to 15 minutes to run. After that, it only takes about a few minutes to run, as it just pulls the updates and compiles the updates to the existing jar file, as long as you keep all your folders intact. As you can see, now the decompiling of the Minecraft itself has started. After this, it will start compiling the Spigot server, and you should get some, if everything goes successful, you should get the jar files here in this folder over here. Now that the decompile has finished for Minecraft files themselves, it is now getting ready to compile spigot/bucket. And now the compiling process begins. And now it's going to apply the update patches. Now it starts running the test against that file. And now here comes the bucket jar being compiled. And now craft bucket. And now running tests. And now it's preparing to build Spigot itself now. We are near the end of the build. It's taken a bit longer than I expected, but since the last time I attempted this and had failure because my computer didn't have firepower, they've made a lot of updates. Yeah, the patching process is over, and now to finish the compilation. Yeah, as you can now see, Spigot has been installed. So if I want to run Spigot, I'll type in this Java jar Spigot as 1.8.jar. After a couple attempts, I had to accept the EULA and allocate RAM, but your server now starts. I will give the commands to be issued in the description, and thanks for watching.